Hi students, this is Viswanath, chemistry faculty for NEET and IIT exams. In last class we completed mesomeric effect. Next one is resonance effect. Before going to this resonance effect, we should know what is resonance. See here, for a molecule, if a single Lewis structure is unable to explain all the properties of that molecule, then we can write two or more Lewis structures or electronic structures for that molecule. In those structures, one structure can explain some of the properties of that molecule, other structure can explain some other properties of that molecule. But no single structure can explain all the properties of that molecule. So the real structure or actual structure of that molecule is in between those electronic structures. These are called resonating structures, and this phenomena is called resonance. So for a molecule, one structure is not possible, two or more structures are possible. In between those structures, actual structure is present. That actual structure is known as resonance hybrid. So actual structure is called resonance hybrid. Those structures are called resonating structures or canonical structures. This resonance we can observe both in inorganic compounds and organic compounds. Example, organic compounds, CO2, simple molecule. In this, two oxygen atoms are attached to the carbon atom by double bonds. So this is the structure of carbon dioxide. If these pi electrons are shifted to this carbon atom, then this lone pair of electrons shifted here, then we can get another structure, that is this one, triple bond. Here negative charge is developed on the oxygen atom. Now same structure, these pi electrons are shifted to this oxygen, this lone pair of electrons are shifted here, then we can get this structure. So here triple bond is formed, positive charge is developed on this oxygen, here negative charge is developed on this oxygen. Structure 1, structure 2, structure 3. So for CO2 molecule, this is the structure. By the interaction of lone pair of electrons and pi bonds, we can get this structure and also this structure. So these structures are called resonance structures of this CO2. Okay, so in this way we can observe this resonance concept or resonance phenomena in CO2. Another example, in case of ions also we can observe this resonance phenomena. Example, carbonate ion CO3 2 minus. See here, C double bond O, oxygen, lone pair of electrons, here also lone pair of electrons, negative charge, here two lone pairs are there. Now interaction of lone pair of electrons takes place here and pi bond. When this lone pair is, this charge is shifted at this position, pi electrons are shifted to this oxygen, then we can get three lone pair of electrons and negative charge is developed on this oxygen. This oxygen becomes double bond is developed here, here charge remains as it is. So in this way, these pi electrons are shifted to this, negative charge developed here, negative charge shifted here, single bond becomes double bond. Now in the next step, this pi electrons are shifted here, this lone pair of electrons are shifted here, then we can get CO, single bond O, negative charge, and here also negative charge, and here it becomes double bond. Okay, So in this way, due to the interaction of lone pair and pi bond, we can get different types of structures for the same ion. All these are called resonating structures. Now from these resonating structures, we can get a resonance hybrid. That means actual structure of this carbonate ion, that is CO, this one. So in this way, pi electrons are shifted between this oxygen and carbon, this oxygen and carbon, this oxygen and carbon. So this is the resonance hybrid for carbonate ion. Okay, now when we are writing resonance structures, we should remember some rules for writing resonance structures. First one is, all the resonance structures should have same number of unpaired electrons. Resonance structures should have same number of unpaired electrons. And second one, resonance structures should have same number of electrons, that means, second one, all the resonance structures should differ, only in the position of electrons, but not in the position of atoms. That means if I observe different resonating structures, in all these structures only electrons position is differed, but there is no change in the position of atoms. Third one is, all the resonating structures should have nearly same energy, So when we are writing resonating structures, we should remember these rules. Next, for a particular ion or compound, different resonating structures are there. All the resonating structures cannot contribute to the same extent for resonance hybrid. Some structures contribute more to the resonance hybrid, some other structures contribute less for the resonance hybrid. So which one can contribute more, which one can contribute less, means there are some conditions are there. See that relative contributions of resonance structures, in this four conditions are there. First one, the resonance structures with greater number of covalent bonds, contribute more to resonance hybrid. See the example. Less number of covalent bonds are there, then its contribution is less for resonance hybrid. For example, 1,3-butadiene or 1,3-diene, both are same. See this, 1,3-butadiene means this one, CH2 double bond CH, when these pi electrons are shifted here, then we can get CH2, this is negative charge, this is positive charge, electrons shifted to this carbon, so it can acquire a negative charge, pi electrons are shifted here, so this carbon acquires positive charge in this way. Okay, now same compound, electron shifting takes place in another way, that is this one. These pi electrons are shifted here, these pi electrons are shifted here, then we can get CH2, CH, double bond CH, CH2 plus structure 1, 2 and 3. So in structure 1 more covalent bonds are there, in this less covalent bonds, here also less covalent bonds than structure 1. So structure 1 contribution is more for the resonance hybrid of this 1,3-butadiene or buta 1,3-diene. Okay students, we'll meet you in the next class.